Cool. Hello, and welcome to everybody. Thank you to be here. Sorry for my terrible English. I will probably hurt your ears. So if you don't understand me, don't hesitate to raise your hand and say, I'm sorry, I don't understand. And Anthony there could probably help me because his English is better than mine. Who I am? My name is Philippe Charrière, so I'm French. I'm Technical Account Manager at GitLab for the EMEA zone and more especially for France. You can see me as a caretaker or a kind of janitor for the customers and to make the glue between the customers and all the team at GitLab. If you have any question, don't hesitate to use my email. My GitLab handle is at key33j, you can pronounce it geek. And I have the same on GitHub, but I cannot display GitHub on my slide, of course. And I'm a Twitter addict, so you can use the third handle if you want to reach me very quickly. Who use already GitLab? Cool. For work? Okay. At the beginning at GitLab, we did plan and create. So we did wiki, issue, and of course, source web management. And after some years, we did all this and some other things, but the slide is too small. What I prefer with the GitLab application is about continuous integration, continuous delivery, review application, and some other things, and sometimes with SAST, static application security testing. I'm very bad with security, but with GitLab sometimes it's easier for me to do that. I will speak about my own GitLab workflow. At the beginning, in fact, I was more a developer than an ops. I think I probably never become an ops because it's too difficult for me. But I have some questions before. How many of you are developers? Okay. Ops? Almost the same. Project manager? Okay, just one. I was a former project manager. And something else? Yes?
I'm a UX designer.
Okay, nice.
Designers.
Okay. And there are some nice features on GitLab about UX design, but I think I'm not the most relevant person to demo with this. I only know how to do some source code. So my workflow is very simple. GitLab is very is agnostic with development workflow. Mine is, I use the master branch for the production, and each time I need a feature, I create a merge request, a feature branch, I test it, and then when all is okay, I merge it on the master branch, and automatically it's deployed on the production. So we call it feature flow. GitHub is the same, and they call it GitHub flow. We have GitLab flow, but it's a little bit more complicated. So with this simple workflow, we had, of course, automatic testing, but we have the CI pipeline to follow all the tests, all the security scan, quality scan, and of course, approbation. And when we merge, we deploy on production. Who use this kind of workflow? Okay. The other, it's more complicated, like Git flow, for example, or you don't use merge request or pull request. So that, no? Don't hesitate to speak in English. I can, so you can. Okay. I almost finished with the slideware. I will try to do some demonstration. all is on my laptop, even the deployment platform. For that, I use OpenFAS. Who knows OpenFAS? Okay, more than usual, in fact. OpenFAS is, you can see it as a layer on Kubernetes or on Docker Swarm. Alex is the tech lead of OpenFAS, so don't repeat what I say. It's like a mini OpenShift on Kubernetes. And so you can use Kubernetes without knowing Kubernetes because OpenFAS is very easy to use. You can use, it's a, with containers, so you can use several languages, of course. And very important, the community is very friendly. So you can ask it all silly question, you already find somebody to help you. And on my laptop, I have a GitLab server in Docker, OpenFAS server, not on Kubernetes, on Docker Swarm, because I'm learning Kubernetes, so I wasn't ready to do this with Kube. I have some runner, two Docker runners, perhaps one, no, not the shell runner, it's a mistake. On my runners, I have the OpenFAS CLI to deploy the function or the application and other some tools. And I have an external Docker registry. And I like Risk, so I love Risk. I use my sidekick, Jay. It's a bot that helps me. And he told me what I have to do during the demonstration because I have no memory. I'm like a fish god. So, I don't need the slide anymore. Okay, it's not the same resolution. Everybody can read? Okay.
Yes, we can.
Thank you. take this presentation like an English training for me. I will create a project, very simple. It's an application to deploy just a static web page on OpenFAS. And I will add different parts in my CI script to do a lot of things on my project. With GitLab, you can create a template project, so it's useful for teams and for demonstration. So I have something already usable. I have no imagination, so I think it's a good title for an application. So it used the GitLab API to import the project from a template. And the templates are in a group, like any other Git project. So it's a very simple application that displays HTML code. I said at the beginning that all starts with an issue. So I will use it. And I will ask to my bot, what is my first task? There is a little latency because my laptop is not very powerful. 5 or 7 seconds, if all is okay. And nothing is okay. Oh, yes. I forgot to put the webhook in the integration. So my bot is an Express.js application. And it's listening on comments, issue events, and merge request events. So I have my first task. In fact, it's I have to deploy my application on the master branch. So I will create a merge request from my issue. If you do that, like that, each time you close the merge request, each time you merge, close the issue automatically. I will use the web IDE because it's a demonstration, but don't do that in real life. Use a real IDE. I will add a Docker file. Like the project, you can have templates. Mine is very simple. And I will add a GitLab CI YAML file to deploy my project. This file, who use GitLab CI? And who use Jenkins? Okay. This file is like the Jenkins files, in fact. So you put it in the at the root of the project, and the runners, it's like Jenkins slave, for example, is pulling the GitLab instance, and if there is something to do, they read the YAML file. So I define a stage, deploy. You are not obliged to put emoji in the YAML file, but it's nicer. But it works. In this case, I have only one stage, and then after I define job. So I have a deploy job. It belongs to the deploy stage. I explain that you do the job only if something happened on the master branch. I define an environment, so you can give it the name you want. So most of the time for the master branch, I name it production slash the project name. It's an environment variable from GitLab, and the feature branch, the branch name. After, it's a web app, so I define a dynamic URL to reach my application, and then I write a bash script to deploy my application. So if you know how to do something in a terminal, you can use it directly in the YAML file. If you work on Windows, you can use PowerShell instead of bash. So to deploy a FAS application is very simple. In fact, it's the FAS CLI-UP, and I use a config file to deploy my application. And the stop job is only if I want to destroy my application, in fact. Never do that on the master branch. So I will commit on the feature branch. It will start nothing because nothing happened on the master branch, sorry. So to deploy, I just only have to delete the source branch and merge on the master branch. We have to wait for the pipeline. So from GitLab, you can watch the pipeline, and you can add the output. So this is in the runner. The runner git clone the project and do what is explained in the YAML file. It's almost okay. Yes. So now if I go to the operation environment menu, you can see my new environment here, and I can reach my application here. So you can see that it's a very nice web application. No, I will tell at my bot that the application is deployed. Okay. Who knows the concept of review application in GitLab? Nobody. It's something very easy to use to start or pop up a Docker container, a virtual machine, or what your deployment platform allows you to, from a feature branch, see the deployment of a developer outside the production. So you almost not need anymore a test platform or a development platform. It's just a temporary application. I will show you how to do that. So my bot asked to me to create a merge request to update my CI script and change the title of the page, and then do a review application. Sorry. So I will change first the title. So and in fact, a real developer needs a Mac because of the emoji are easy to type with OS X. So the change is okay. I will change my YAML file, adding a new stage preview, and I create another job that belongs to the previous stage. This time I said you run it only if something happened on the merge request. The name of my environment changed a little. I name it preview, but after I use again the project name variable and the branch name variable. The URL is dynamic again, so I have nothing to change. But very important, you need this all stop, play the remove job, because when you merge on the production, you need to delete the Docker or the preview application. The first time I did it, it was on a French PaaS platform named Clever Cloud. And at the end of the day, they called me saying, you have 50 VM on the platform. Is it normal? I forgot the unstop and remove. With the script, I deploy my review application. The job remove has to be manual, because if you forgot this, you deploy and it will be deleted automatically. It happened only on merge request. The action is stopped, and with the CLI of OpenFAS, I remove my application. This logic exists with anything. I have another demonstration, but I need a bigger laptop or server. I do very easily the same thing with OpenShift. I will commit on the feature branch, sorry. We are waiting a little for the runner. So you can see it's not the same stage. It's deploying. I can go to the merge request. Oh, it's already deployed. Oh yes, too fast. So I just refresh. You can see it, the new environment. I can see my review application. I'm not on the production. The production is here, I can refresh it. If I go again to operation environments, you can see the two environments. You can reach it from here. You can stop an environment, redeploy an environment if you have the appropriate credential. So I just told that I changed the title. Okay, so he asked me to merge on master to deploy on production, and after going to another issue.
for the moment. I will. Just waiting for a second. I have two pipelines, one for remove the review application and the other to deploy in the production. So if I go on the environment, you see I have only the production environment and not working, okay. Demo issue. Yeah, so the review application was merged and my update is on production. No, the new issue is about quality test, quality scanning in the GitLab. In GitLab, in the starter edition, we have a feature named code quality, and we use an open source tools to do the scan of quality. I can't remember the name of the tools, but something is very important. You can plug your own tools on these features. So you can write your own analyzer on scan or use even SonarQube, for example. But you have to create a script to modify the payload of SonarSource to display it in the merge request. So in this case, I have to find mushroom in the source code. So I first to change it. I need to this. The first time I need to this to do this on the master branch because the runner will compare the two source code. I need to change my. So I add a new stage. You can write some CI script outside the main script and import it from other projects, for example. This one don't run, I prefix it with a dot to not execute it. I will use this one. So in fact, I extend my file and I use the script inside to search the mushroom in the cost sort. I will show you the script. Don't do this in production. You can create kind of module in an external script. So mine search emoji mushroom with a grep, and after I use Node.js to create the JSON report. And if your tool is able to create the same JSON report with the same structure, you can plug it in GitLab, in fact. And just that all, I just had to precise that I use a report for code quality with this name. You have to use each time this name. So I don't know if I add some mushroom, no. Okay. Once again, the power of OS X. No, I will commit directly on the master branch. I know it's not a good practice, but it's for the demonstration. I'm waiting for the runner. So if I find a mushroom, it's okay. Just before I forgot, all the variables I use are defined at the level of the project or a group in the settings and the CI variables here. So all my credentials or all that I need to deploy is here. Now I will update my code again. mushroom. I will remove the mushroom. I will commit on the merge request. So you can see that a pipeline is nicer with emoji. We saw that there is no more mushroom in the source code. So if I go again in the merge request and I do a refresh, oh, I don't need refresh. So the feature of code quality detect that the code quality was improved on one point, and you can see where. And when there is a new mushroom, you can click it and have a pop-up or a link to see where is the mushroom. It's not a good example in this case. So it's a way to add feedback in the merge request. You can do this for test. For example, if your framework is able to generate a JUnit report, you can display it as a widget inside the merge request like this. So, we have another feature in the Ultimate Edition. Which is the vulnerabilities management, and we use a lot of analyzer, but you can already use the analyzer. They are open source, so you can run it even with GitLab Core. The Ultimate Edition provides the UI to manage the vulnerabilities and to allow you to follow the progress of the correction. So I will merge again. So this time I will use the same thing as the previous demonstration. I will use the feature of GitLab Ultimate, the vulnerability report, but I will create my own analyzer, in fact, and you can do this. Most of the time you have to do this with a template that is provided by GitLab in Go. I'm not a Go developer, so I did it with Node.js and shell script. And for the demonstration, the vulnerabilities are some animals in the source code. I have to confess that I'm the only person at GitLab that doing this kind of thing. I will change the CI. Okay, so I add a new stage, security. I import a new helper, and my we don't need the quality this time. Oh yes, it will be nicer. And my new job to search the animal in the source code is here. My other YAML file look like that. It's again a grep, and I totally reformat the JSON report, and the name to use is GI dependency scanning report, and then you can do the demonstration or use it as your own analyzer. We have other scanning like dependency scanning and container scanning to sort the vulnerability. If you want the source code to do the same at home and not at work, don't hesitate to ask me. I think I'm okay. I will commit on the feature branch. We are waiting for the runner. So here, this is the stages, and here is the job. And you can do parallel jobs. There is a keyword for that, if you want. So if I some vulnerabilities, this is the report. If I return to the merge request, and if demogod are with me, not totally with me. So I don't know why. So he said that there is some vulnerabilities, but probably I have a problem with my report. I said that it's experimental, but I think if I expand it, no. You can see the full report like this. So you find a panda, a lion, and a tiger. And when you find a real vulnerability, you can see where it is, of course. You can decide to say it's not a real vulnerability and dismiss the vulnerability, or create an issue to explain to the team that there is something to do, and you can even after fork the project to fix the vulnerability directly. I will try to update something to show you the vulnerabilities inside the app. Okay, I think it's a UI problem. So you can see the vulnerability here. And I can click here, dismiss it. If I go to the group report, you can see that I create a lot of vulnerabilities to prepare the demonstration, and you can follow the progress in this chart. Where is my... Okay, so I will remove all the... all the animals. I had a panda, but I can't remember where. Yes. I commit. Just waiting for the runner again. If I go inside the output, normally display that there is no more animals. Okay, and if I return inside the merge request, I have the error again. Okay, normally it displays that there is no vulnerabilities. Perhaps I need to wait for the deployment. Yes. So we can see in real time the bug inside GitLab. So security scanning detects no vulnerabilities. And it's okay. So I explained that I kill all the animals. This kind of feedback and the previous feedback You can do this, but you need the enterprise version of GitLab. There is something that you can use to give feedback to a merge request with each version of GitLab using the GitLab API. So I will just show it to you. For example, I want to be able to do some load testing on my review application. And display the report inside the merge request. In fact, inside a node of the merge request. So for this, I will change the last time my CI script. I add a stress stage. And at the end, I put something using some variable, and I extend another script. For this script, I use a simple tool. The name is A. I think the developer has the same imagination as me. It's a Go program that allows you to stress very quickly a web application after. With Node.js, I keep the data and transform it to put it in a node in the merge request using a curl request and the GitLab API. And I use the CI merge request IID. In fact, you can get this variable when you are doing a job with the keyword only merge request. It's the way to keep this variable. And then when you have this ID, you can add node to the GitLab merge request. So I just commit and it will be the end.
2 minutes to wrap up, please.
2 minutes, yes. Okay. Well, in 2 minutes, I think it will be finished.
Okay.
So. Load testing part. Most. So we generate the report. And he add with the API the result of the report inside the merge request. So for free, you can add feedback inside the merge request using the GitLab API. And I just finished my demonstration. For the question, I have no time, so you can reach me outside, of course. And that's all.
Thank you.